had the strength of family, numbers, she didn't need big tasks, but this guy, on the other hand, he's traveling alone, and then he tasks for essentially survival. So that's the second way we can tell apart. Now, looking back at him some more, we've got the spinal region here, and then we have some large bones next to that that are actually a spinal extension. And these would be pretty muscular. You could also call them acanthosaurs. As you look at the pictures again, you're going to see each one of these animals has a lot behind the skull. And that would have been necessary to support all the weight coming off the bone. Now, we've also got ribs here and ribs here. And I'd like to point out this one area in the big circular that we've got. That is a broken rib that's been healing for about 1 year. So we know it didn't happen during the flood. Happened about a year prior. Anybody got a theory on what happened to that rib? A fight. And that's what we think too. You can imagine two males going head to head. They're just going to keep banging on each other until you get a headache and quit. But if you're really smart, you're going to come inside and do a jab to the rib cage with your tusk. And that's what we think.